All right, in this next video, we're going to be showing y'all how to bend a simple 90 on a Chicago bender. Now, a couple different pieces of information that you're going to need on this bender. Number one is our D-duct. We have a 1-inch sticker rigid here. So if we look down at our table on the side of our bender, which is hard to read, especially out in the field on these benders when they have the rust and different parts and pieces on here, but we can make out that for a 1-inch 90 is going to be an 11-inch D-duct. And so here on our stick of conduit that we're going to be bending, we've got a predetermined length of 40 inches. So what we're going to do is we're going to take and deduct that 11 inches from that 40, just like what we was doing with our hand bender. So we're going to take 40 minus 11, which gives us 29. And just like before, we're going to take that mark all the way around that conduit so we can see it. And again, we're going to say this on every video that we're marking conduit on, but always use a pencil. Never use a Sharpie. We don't want those Sharpie marks to bleed through or to be seen in the final product. So once we have our mark on our conduit here, all we're going to do is get our conduit set up in the bender. And for this, on our hand benders, we was making sure our mark was on that arrow on that bender. On these, we just have to make sure that it's right on the edge, front edge of that shoe. So once we get that in there, the Chicago benders, get it nice and tight so it don't move around. And our next piece is this, our gauge on the side. We have a nipple here on the top of this bender that shows what angle that's going to be at. We're just going to bend this until it hits that 90 degree mark on that gauge. The good thing about these Chicago benders, you're not having to keep that constant pressure like you would when you're bending by hand. Now, once we get right towards the end there, you have to really be careful not to overbend this conduit. And there we go, we're at our 90 there. Now what we're going to do is, now that we got this bent, we're just going to measure and make sure our measurements are correct, and we have a 40 inch 90 here. And right at 40 inches, we're good to go.